that meat and no potato.
Welcome at Swingbase. In this video, we're gonna show you like some ways of doing the swing out. Actually, like you have thousands of ways of doing swing outs, yes? And everyone is being different. So we're not just telling you how to do like the swing out. It's just about like a way to approach the swing out. So in a different video, we're talking more like about coming from a promenade.
Going straight.
And having the partner going straight, having maybe a less rotated way to get into the swivels or less rotated swing out. In this one, we're gonna maybe go to a bit higher level, talking about way of approaching the posture, going into the swivels, waiting, playing with the distance.
Yes.
So quite a lot of things to talk about.
Let's go.
So yes. So things that stay the same is like about the way to get started. Boom. And sending the partner. So you can see here on 5-6 we have boom, 5-6, 7-8, and I'm gonna rotate a little bit more my partner.
Yes.
First thing, like I have a list of things in my head. I always have. Like before I go
That's
to sleep, I'm like.
Characteristic.
So actually, we don't think much about it, but it's very important. It's about connection with the hands. Because if we start from here, something I often see is we think we don't need the hand at all. So we're like kind of having loose connection. And then I send my partner and we're like, shit.
Something went wrong.
Yes. And it's going to be very hard to keep connected because from the beginning, this one was not really like there. So something you can think about it, maybe you can say how you connect with your hand.
It's like a hook. You can do it on your own, yeah, you kind of place, like it's a leader and a follower, and you place them together like this, and it's locked, like you cannot disconnect them. And this is sort of the same way, you want all of your fingers to be connected, not just the tip, because then your fingers will die, so really, or slip.
Yeah, you know. So for the leaders, something you can do is you can put all your fingers into the hand of your partner. You can also free your index and put it to the side. About the dump, don't do crazy things with that. Just like, don't push your partner, just keep it simple, having your frame. But yes, don't put your pressure that you have in your head about leading like on the hand of your partner.
Yeah.
So that will be the beginning.
Important because we want to use each other a bit.
So you do it now and it saves you later. Arm is kind of relaxed.
Yeah.
The fingers are connected, yeah, being engaged. So second thing that we often forget is we think a lot about, we think a lot about this connection, about like, oh, I need to send my partner into swing out. But actually as a human, we have two sides, yes? And there's two bright sides, yes? There is no dark side. When we hit, so we want to connect also with the full body. And we have also a connection here, yes? It doesn't have to be tense. It's just like my body is going away from my partner and taking my partner with me. And then it helps me also to send my partner into a swing out because I'm connected from both sides. One, two, two, boom. To kiddo. Ah. This creates also like kind of extra rotation because I'm not placing myself.
It's not super straight.
From the partner. It's a bit more delayed in the rotation, creating then for the partner.
I have like a turning in on six.
Do you want to talk about it?
Yeah, because in another video that we did, we just simply had so much time to go into the swivels and it was easy, not a lot of twisting. But here we really have this energy where we rotate and then we land on six. You can see how much turned in I am just because I go with the energy. I don't stop myself, but I go with it. And from here, seven and eight, it's so perfect to go into the swivels after. Yeah, so I really come in 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. Too. And you can.
It's cool. It's cool.
You're really.
I'm enjoying it.
Don't go crazy. I mean, you know, counterbalance and all, which I like to use, but it depends on the leader you dance with, and you don't have to go crazy. But this, like, you can do it on your own, and it's really nice to use as much movement as you can.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, oh, one, two, and three, and four, six, and seven. Also, as a leader, one thing which is important, you can see that we're kind of mirroring each other. I mean, I wouldn't go into the swivels. I could. I could be like and swiveling with my partner. But because my job is like, if I want to go, for example, in another swing out, is to create the next momentum. So I'm from here, I'm going to just like open slightly and go into my rock step and bring my partner back. And then get back. Yes. So try to not open too early because you're going to kind of disconnect from your partner.
Mm-hmm.
So it helps to stay like, to go in on six and then open into the last triple step.
So maybe another thing that we can talk about is on the swivels, we tend to go forward very fast, seven, eight, and then one, two. And maybe we can think about staying back a bit more. One, two, and three, and four. And saving the energy of two for this three where we really connect super fast. Badu ashu bau bida. Yeah, it's like a chewing gum, slingshotty something feeling. Shu bida. One, two, three, and four. Yeah.
Nice. And maybe one thing I can share with the leaders, because it's something it took me a while to understand. And as I said, like you don't have one way of doing the swing out. But it made a kind of a big difference to me because I was usually like going rock, step, and rushing back to my partner on two. So being like one, two, and triple, sending my partner, going one, two, and triple step. And you can see that I'm starting to travel this way.
Oh, all of a sudden we're here.
And it was like also for faster swing out kind of difficult because I was thinking so much about instead of going back, to run back to my partner to continue dancing. And at the end, it's kind of counterproductive.
Mm-hmm.
So what I mean is like instead of going one and rushing back to your partner, you can sit a little bit in your two. Yes, going one, two, and three. Boom. Boom. So using your two to give this extra movement to your partner. Boom. Two, kidu, one, two, and three. Per step. Yes, so this slightly going back on two also give your partner this extra energy to come back. Yes. So we had it from the side-by-side position.
Yes.
Being here, we had it also from the
woo
open position. And then if you want to loop it, we're going to talk about the last thing, is you want to kind of reach the same position you had on three and four from the side-by-side.
Yes.
The difference is you go from this open position.
So you have a longer way to go.
And you can see that here I'm also connecting again with my partner, keeping my arm close to me, not losing it here, but like it's like I want to be here and travel, yes, into my swing out. If I would be here, my arms are there, and if I'm here, I'm here. And then I can travel and take my partner with me.
Yeah, and fellas, be careful that you don't. You can also sit back a little. Sit back always means this sort of position on three and four, that on one,
sorry,
one two, you don't do this. Oh. And you want to run because you feel like you have to go for it. But wait and search for the connection here and wait until the next sending out comes because, again, you are kind of woo-bee-doo. Waiting for the energy, woo, and then it comes back to you. You really don't have to run anywhere. So really sit back into the hand and feel the connection there.
Yes. So, what I would say, we have it. We show you one more time.
Ba-a-shoo, be-do, ba-five, six, seven, and a one, two, three, and four. Six, seven, and shoot, ba-woo, be-da, do-ki-da.